The government's giving a major funding boost to food banks as people struggle to feed themselves and their families over the lockdown period. Demand has soared by 900% in some areas, and a number of people are receiving food grants from the government. That's also tripled compared to this time last year. With more, let's go to May Heron. May.
Today's $30 million package is really a sign that some families out there are really doing it tough. Don't forget, this is already on top of $27 million that was handed out last month. Now, this new money will go towards food parcels, packages that will have essential household items, as well as emergency accommodation. A short time ago, I spoke to Civil Defence Minister Pine Henare, and he said this money is really there to fill in the gaps where there is significant need. He identified South Auckland, low socio-economic communities, as well as rural areas where there are a growing number of people who are desperately in need. A heartbreaking sight, not seen to this extent before in South Auckland. Hundreds lining up for food in a queue snaking around the corner.
Some of them have waited 2 hours. We're having to go out with trolleys of food, feeding them with rolls and buns and hot cross buns, water for example.
People were eventually stopped from joining for fear food would run out.
They have been here almost 20 years. Today, quite frankly, is manic. It's the busiest day we've ever had.
Many here, including these Filipino builders, have lost their job.
This is the first time that we receive a subsidy.
We're suffering, especially the food.
And then the lockdown is still next week, and then I don't know what happened.
It's the same story across the country. Demand at Wellington City Mission is up 400%, while some Salvation Army sites are seeing a 900% increase.
As each week goes by, the numbers are increasing, which is a concern for us in terms of our ability to meet that need.
For us, this is massive. This is way bigger than anything we have ever seen in the 116 years history of the Wellington City Mission.
This Wellington Hospitality Group's meeting soaring demand for government food grants, which have now jumped nearly 70,000. Waiters, baristas and bartenders instead preparing 6,000 frozen meals every day. That's over 180 kilograms of rice.
Jacinda told us to care and be good people, and that's what these guys are being.
Many of these parcels are going to people who have never had help before, some who have lost employment suddenly.
We're going into houses where there's quite large families and solo parents, so you know, you really see people are struggling.
We learned very quickly that we shouldn't judge the house that somebody's living in or where they're living. People are desperate for food.
The government acknowledging that need with today's funding boost.
Into the fourth week of lockdown, it's become clear for some whānau that the employment status has changed, income has changed, and now it's really starting to bite.
Money will be handed out in the next 24 to 48 hours, showing just how urgent this emergency is.
And bring May in again. May, there are pleas for the public to help too.
Yeah, so you heard there in the piece that the need is really great. And so while the government grants will go a long way, public donations are welcomed. The Mangere Services Centre has already set up a Give a Little page, and they say while they've got a lot of fresh food, what they're missing out on is canned food. And the reason why this is so important is there's a really sad prediction here that as the weeks go by, or coming, as the weeks come, we're expecting more and more people to need these food parcels. And so that is why that these services are pleading for more public help as the number of people needing grows.
May Heron, thank you.